people ask that if we become spiritual, Swamiji, then will we also have to give up our work? No, 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 that's not what the Gita is all about. The Gita is not teaching us to give up work. It's teaching us how to change our attitude to the work, the consciousness we bring to it. See, one temple is being built and workers have come all the way from different states. They're working, sweating it out in the sun. You ask them, why are you working? I'll get money at the end of the day. That is one consciousness. Another, oh, you know, this is very satisfying for me. It gives me great pleasure. Another, oh, this is a work of God. Let me dedicate myself to it. So working out there, the activity is the same. But the consciousness has changed so much. So karma yoga involves a change of consciousness. This is like a sure shot way of reducing stress. Now, how do we go in that direction? Now, Sri Krishna goes ahead to talk about karma yoga.
Bhagavad Gita sloka chanting is followed by translation and commentary by Swami Mukundananda.
कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन मा कर्म फल हेतुर्भूः मा ते संगोत्स्व कर्मणि.
You have a right to perform your prescribed duties, but you are not entitled to the fruits of your actions. Never consider yourself to be the cause of the results of your activities, nor be attached to inaction.
So here, Sri Krishna says, Arjun, to go towards God, you will not have to stop working. You will have to change your attitude towards work. That is all that is required. A change of the attitude. What was the difference that came about? Not the work was just the same. The difference was in his consciousness, his attitude towards that work. Earlier he was looking upon this war as an opportunity to take vengeance upon Duryodhan and win back the throne of Hastinapur. After hearing the Bhagavad Gita, he is detached. Doesn't matter, many kings came and went. It's not going to lead anywhere. But I have to do my duty. And I let me do it as a service to God. The internal attitude changed. So, it's often a misnomer. People ask that if we become spiritual, Swamiji, then will we also have to give up our work? Do we have to become a Swamiji like yourself? You know, very often when I give lectures, people, they immediately come. So, if I believe what you are saying, will I have to give up my work? No, 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 that's not what the Gita is all about. The Gita is not teaching us to give up work. It's teaching us how to change our attitude to the work, the consciousness we bring to it. Once I was reading the statements of a Zen master. So Zen is all about attitudes, a dry kind of philosophy. So he was asked, what did you used to do before you became a Zen master? He said that I used to cut the wood and I used to fill the water from the river and carry it out here. Now that you have become enlightened, what do you do? He says, I cut the wood and I fill the water and I carry it out here. What is the difference? The difference is earlier I was doing it without awareness. Now I am doing it with complete awareness. Again, a change of attitude. But here in Karma Yoga, we add devotion to it. I am doing this for the pleasure of God. See, one temple is being built in Vrindavan. And workers have come all the way from different states, from Bihar, from Bengal, etc. And they're working, sweating it out in the sun. You ask them, why are you working? I'll get money at the end of the day. That is one consciousness. Another, why are you working? Oh, you know, this is very satisfying for me. It gives me great pleasure. And there have been such sadhus. Temple was made, the sadhus would come and work as laborers out there. Why? Oh, this is a work of God. Let me dedicate myself to it. So working out there, the activity is the same. But the consciousness has changed so much. So Karma Yoga involves a change of consciousness. Towards what? Towards the fruit of our work. We are working in material consciousness for the fruit, that I will get the fruit of my work for my enjoyment. It will make me happy. I will get this prestige, money, comfort, whatever. So the goal is our attachment to the fruit. Now you change that. The fruit is not for me. Then the fruit is for the pleasure of God. Just bring this one change. So you're still working, but for His pleasure. The work continues. The consciousness has changed. So I remember, you know, there was this Chanakya Pandit. There used to be a serial that used to come, Chanakya, many, many years ago. So Chandragupta asks Chanakya in that according to the Vedic philosophy, what is the position of a king? What is the status of a king according to the Vedic philosophy? So Chanakya immediately answers, the king is nothing but the servant of his people. That is God consciousness. Art the enjoyer. I am the servant. Why? Because I am a tiny part of God. My job is to serve God. So I will keep doing my work because that's my nature. If you are by nature a warrior, you will keep doing your work. But you will start doing it for the pleasure of God. So that service attitude naturally creeps up. There's nothing higher than service. The Vedas say that is your constitutional position. You are a tiny part of God. Your constitutional position is to serve God. And your work is a means, a medium of serving Him. So the fruit of that work is not for your pleasure, it is for God. So you, Arjun, are entitled. Karmanne vadhikaraste. You have the adhikar to do your work. Nobody will take it away from you. Ma phaleshu, not the fruits, they are for God. So whether they are good or bad, don't bother. Did you put in your best effort? I did. Fine, good enough. That's all your duty is. You put in your best effort, boss. The results are for God, right? So let them be however they are. That is the test. If poor fruits, we become depressed, then we are attached to the fruits for our sake. And if it doesn't make a difference to us, then we are detached. So the fruits in any case are not in our hands. The fruits of your actions are not in your hands. One person works hard all his life, chasing the great American dream, what to speak of becoming a millionaire. He finds it difficult to make two ends meet. And one person has just landed up from another country and he's settled and adjusted his visa status, and immediately his business starts booming. How did it happen? Was this fellow very intelligent? No, he was ordinary. There's so many factors involved in the results. Not only your effort, your past karmas, your destiny, the situation at hand, the karmas of others prevalent in that society, matter of circumstance, the place where you are in, and sheer luck. All these factors count in determining the result. That's why one student works 14 hours a day and still cannot make it to those Ivy League colleges. The other doesn't do anything and still he sails along. So, Arjun, the results cannot be determined by you. Be prepared. No matter if you put in your best efforts, you may get bad results. But if your philosophy is that the results were for the pleasure of God, then you will be elated. God wanted this? Never mind. If this is the will of God, all right, let me be happy in it. So with this philosophy, immediately releases us from all kinds of tension while yet putting in our best efforts. So that is called NATO, not the North Atlantic Treaty Organization. Then, not attached to the outcome. Not attached to the outcome. You see, each time a person is playing golf, it is always the outcome which is in the mind. What is the score? What is the score? What is the score? Now, he is not enjoying that shot as much because the mind is always up there in the future. Now, just forget about the score. Just focus on enjoying that shot and playing it to the best of your ability. When you forget about the score and just focus on that one shot, you will have the most enjoyable game of golf in your life. Because you use this not attached to the outcome. So Sri Krishna says, Ma phaleshu kadachana. And Ma karma phale turbhur. Don't think that you are the doer. Develop this mentality. God helped me along. He gave me the energy. Others helped along. In other words, don't develop the pride of doing anything. So when you start thinking, you know, he is the source, I am just the instrument, that pride of doing will also go. So in multiple ways, this verse is applicable and beneficial to all who are working in the world. This is like a sure shot way of reducing stress. So further now, Sri Krishna is going to elaborate on Karma Yoga, and then he's going to talk about enlightenment and the diseases of the mind. All these will come along as we wind up this chapter and see what Sri Krishna has to say to Arjuna in the remaining verses.